Good morning, church. It's Saturday morning, and we want to go to Revelation chapter number 7 this morning and just read a little bit of the portion of the Word of God and find some hope and security in what God is doing and how He has revealed to us the future. You know, when God shows us that His fingerprint is upon the Bible, that the Bible belongs to Him, that it's His Word, one of the things He does is He tells us ahead of time what things are going to happen. And here in chapter number 7, we again are in the 7-year tribulation period. The sixth seal is open, and this massive destruction is happening on the world, and there's this sense of helplessness and hopelessness, and people are crying out and running to the caves and scared, and they don't know what to do. Well, God always gives hope to the world. And so what we're going to see in chapter number 7 is after the opening of the sixth seal, there's also revealed kind of a parenthetical statement God makes here, that God calls out some witnesses to declare the gospel to the world, that they're going to be His witnesses on the earth. Now, always remember this, God does not leave Himself without a witness. God always has His witnesses upon the earth who declare the message of salvation and declare righteousness. He uses mankind for that, and so there's always witnesses. And during this time, after God raptures the church and all the Christians are gone, who's going to be the witnesses? Well, God goes back to working with Israel once again. And in verses 1 through about verse number 8, we see that God seals 144,000 witnesses that are going to be His witnesses upon the earth. Later on, He'll also tell us He sends two prophets, two other witnesses that stay in Jerusalem and do mighty signs. And through these witnesses, great multitudes are going to come to faith in Christ. Chapter 7, verse 1, after these things, I saw four angels standing in the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, on the sea, or any tree. Then I saw another angel ascending from the east, having a seal of the living God, and he cried out with a loud voice. And this is what he says in verse 3. Do not harm the earth, or the sea, or the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God on their foreheads. And he says the number of them were 144,000. So before God allows destruction to come upon the earth, in this 7-year tribulation period, God seals His 144,000 Jewish witnesses. Now, I know they're Jewish because if you go to verse 5 down through verse number 8, it tells us what tribe they're from. And so these are literal Jewish individuals, people who are descendants from Abraham down through Jacob. These are the children of Israel. And although there's two left out, one is Dan and the other is Ephraim. And in Ephraim's place, God puts Joseph. But for some reason, He left out Dan and Ephraim, and I won't get into that theologically. But these are 144,000 people that after the rapture, God brings to salvation. He puts the seal upon them. The seal of the Holy Spirit is what Paul calls it in Ephesians. And they are sealed with the Holy Spirit. 144,000 go into this 7-year tribulation period, and we're going to see later on that 144,000 come out. And therefore, these are people who cannot die. If you will, there are 144,000 Apostle Pauls that God sends into the world. It describes them later on that they do not have families. They're virgin men. In other words, they don't have family, don't have wives, and they're free like Paul was to roam the earth. And through these men, we're going to see that a great multitude will be saved. We'll look at that next time, that God is going to call upon the earth. But just remember this, God always has witnesses. And in this dispensation of time, it's the church. Everyone sealed with the Holy Spirit that have received God's Holy Spirit, we received, according to Acts 1:8, God's Holy Spirit to give us power to become His witnesses. And we need to make sure we do that. Let's be faithful. Can you imagine one of these 144,000 who know that the time is very near and that the judgment of God is being poured out upon the earth, and they would not go and tell people about what God is doing and the salvation He's provided to take away the helplessness and hopelessness of the world? How selfish that would be. And let's make sure we do our job. Our job is now to look at the signs and see that the rapture could be any time and the return of Christ. And even if not, we're to go out and give hope and help to the world by sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Let us be faithful witnesses. Let's pray together. Father, as we go forth today, I pray that you'll bring into our lives people that we can share the gospel with. We want to be your witnesses. And Father, we do believe the things that are soon to come upon the earth are going to be devastating, and people need help and hope. And so we just pray that you'll help us to be able to give it to them through Christ Jesus, who is Lord of all. In his holy name we pray. Amen.